Welcome to another episode of Beer Quest. I'm again Kirk. We're back again for some reason. I guess a few people watch this, so yeah. Phil's at his house, James is over there, and I guess I'm gonna try beer again. Alright, well, let's get into it. We again have three beers that I'm going to try, and then I have my cider for after. And then Phil's got three beers as well.
And if I'm not mistaken, because they're in the fridge right now, so I actually drink them cold, but like, if I'm not mistaken, they're all IPAs, so this will be horrible.
Okay. All right. So, we're going to get started here with SPF by Goose Island Beer Company. I can only assume by the name it tastes like fucking sunscreen. Why else would it?
Yeah.
It better have like some protective qualities. All right, here we go. Oh no. Yeah.
I don't even remember what kind of beer that was.
It says it somewhere. Ale with natural passion fruit flavoring. Yeah. So that tastes very bitter. It tasted a lot like the Corona lot from last time.
Oh, no.
Not a fan of it.
No.
I sent the pictures of these to a friend, and she said she tried it, and all she told me was it didn't taste like sunscreen. She didn't tell me if it was good or bad. All right. Moving on to this middle one is a vanilla porter by Breckenridge Brewery. It's 5.4% ABV. It's very dark.
Yeah, this is one of the ones I gave you because I want to see your face.
I don't want to do this one.
James will probably enjoy this one.
James will probably enjoy it. Fuck. It's not as bad as the SPF. It doesn't have as strong of a taste.
You made no face.
It's not that strong of a flavor. I don't care for it, but it's not completely horrible.
Like you made no face. I'm actually really impressed.
It tastes very, like, coffee-ish.
Okay, yeah, I mean, porter, that makes sense.
It tastes like, yeah, I don't like it.
Like a vanilla coffee.
Yeah. It's not as bad as that one, though. Sorry to disappoint you.
Well, since you would think that since you like the fruitier things, that the one with the passion fruit would be easier for you to drink.
But to be fair, I also love strong vanilla flavoring.
Yeah.
And I feel like the vanilla flavor kind of covers up the beerness of that. Don't get me wrong, I still don't like it. I'm still not gonna buy it. All right, last one for me is Wild Night Honey Cream Ale by Swamphead Brewery, 5% ABV.
The smell, oh, that was hilarious.
I don't like it.
Did it taste worse than it's, or smell worse than it tasted?
Yes. I don't taste the honey. It tastes like a light beer.
I mean, kind of.
Again, I wouldn't buy any of these.
Of course.
I'm sticking with my cider because they're delicious. This one has an aftertaste that lingers, though, and I don't like it. It's getting worse as I haven't had it.
So it's just like it's just sitting on your tongue there. Just...
Yeah.
All right, I need James' opinions, though. I need James.
What do we got? All right,
so we've got SPF there. That is 5.5% ABV.
Is this going to kill the coral reefs just like the sunscreen?
Yes. Yeah.
I pour this beer in a coral reef. It's done for.
Uh-huh. Just go dump it off the keys if you hate nature.
Yeah.
I'm not weird here, then.
Are we sure there's not something in this?
I think that might be the beer that I go by myself to taste to be like, hey, I tried these beers too.
Yeah, that it's not good.
Where was this made?
In hell, apparently.
Chicago, Illinois. Is there a sunscreen factory in Chicago?
I don't know why they would need one.
Somebody woke that up.
Oh, because that was the Goose Island one, right? It's made by Goose Island. Yeah, Goose Island is a Chicago brewery.
Phil, have I tried any other Goose Islands?
No, but I almost got you one that I thought you would like.
This one's definitely better than that.
Yeah.
Has he tried the porter yet? He froze for a second. No, yeah, okay. Not there yet.
We're on Swaphead.
Yeah. No, I almost got you. Goose Island has two different types of beers that are brewed in wine barrels. And I almost got you one of those this time around. They have Sophie and then another one. And I came close because those are actually two of my favorite beers.
Well, if all of their beers taste like that.
They don't. They're usually better. Okay. Apparently. I've never had their SPF one. All right.
And then after this, I'm going to try. Phil got me a special beer.
I did. I did. Yeah, I got you a present.
So I'll go grab that in a sec.
It's one of my favorites.
I'm not surprised that you enjoyed this.
Well, I didn't say I enjoyed it. It was my least hated today.
Okay. So, but I'm not surprised that this was number one of the day.
Because I love vanilla.
Who doesn't? It's nice and simple. Sweet.
Mm-hmm. Wow, this is fantastic.
Yeah, it doesn't have the, like, dark flavor I was afraid it would.
Yeah.
No.
I want to try that one now because it looked amazing.
Honestly, it tastes lighter than the other two. Oh,
that's crazy.
Vanilla aftertaste.
Yeah. Yeah. That's crazy because you would expect that to, like, be harsher with it being such a dark beer. But
I mean, I enjoy dark. Mm-hmm. But this is, I'm impressed by this.
Honestly, if I were out somewhere and they didn't have cider, I'm just like, I have to get drunk. But they had that, I would consider
it. I'm going to count that as a big win.
I would consider it. Only if I'm like, I'm out at this place, I absolutely have to get drunk tonight. Or if
the only cider they have is absolutely garbage.
No, I'd go with the absolutely garbage cider before that.
There are some dry ciders that I think are harsher than beers sometimes. But yeah, I got James my favorite, since he liked the peanut butter stout before, I got him my favorite one.
So, this is Sweet Baby Jesus.
You have to say it with a southern accent.
Say it with a southern accent?
Yeah.
You say it.
This is Sweet Baby Jesus.
Oh no. No, never do that again.
Chocolate.
Yeah, it's my favorite because I know you really liked the chocolate peanut butter stout I got him last time. That's
my favorite. This will have to go up.
Yeah, it'll have to go up next to the other one.
I mean, that's
just a lone beer kick bottle on the shelf.
That is specifically why that's specifically why I ended up with the vanilla porter too. Was so we had another bottle because last time I only got all cans, and we need to continue the quest to decorate your house. That's the side quest in this.
Oh, is that part of the quest?
James, who drinks the least out of all of us.
Beer bottles randomly. All right. See what
you're going to be like a college frat boy.
Wow.
Yeah, it's one of my favorites.
Wow.
So good.
Oh, my goodness.
I found two beers that James is going to be, like, going for. Like,
this is... Yeah, wow. You want to try this?
Not really.
I think you should, for posterity.
Yeah.
Well, a bonus for the week. You've already got your woodchuck.
Thank you, bro. I appreciate it.
Okay, I was wrong. Not all of mine are IPAs. I got one Saison, which is a sour with salt in it. So it's extra bitter.
Mm-hmm.
So the first one I'm going to torture myself with is called Hop On IPA.
Okay.
It's...
Is it a Dr. Seuss book?
Juicy... Huh?
Is it a Dr. Seuss book?
Right? Nah, it looks like it's based off a trolley. It's by...
Oh, so Mr. Rogers.
Mr. Rogers beer.
Right, pretty much.
We all know what a lush Mr. Rogers was.
He said we all know what a lush Mr. Rogers was. Let's see.
Is he lush?
No.
Oh, I was like,
not at all.
Did you see the documentary?
Yeah, they left that part out.
Sorry, Janet. I didn't see that part.
But it says it's 6% alcohol. It is. They describe it as hop on board this juicy pail. It's packed with Cascade,
juicy.
Right? Juicy, with Cascade, Citra, and I can't pronounce that word. Hops, and has hazy appearance with a fresh, juicy. Oh, yeah. I'm gonna go grab one of our fancy chalices real quick.
What's that word, Shannon?
Equinox.
Okay.
Oh, you're gonna do it.
Yeah, I'm gonna do one of the Stella chalices so we can properly see my beers this time. Like, okay. I mean, you guys you have yours in glasses,
yeah.
So.
Yep.
Yes, it does have the haziness, I see that.
Uh-huh, yeah. Looks nice and fancy.
Oh, it smells like Christmas.
Smells like what?
It's
Christmas.
Like, you know, when I look at a Christmas tree, my first thought is, I'd love to drink that.
I want to put that in my mouth. I'm a cat, right? Like... I forgot how many EBUs this was because I was going for high IBU, which is the scale of how bitter a beer is. But it doesn't have the IBUs on the side of their can. So this is brewed in Abita Springs, Louisiana. What sucks is this looks like this should taste good.
Sure.
And I know it's not going to.
It looks like Chardonnay.
I thought Chardonnay was clear.
Yeah, no, that would be if I was handed that as a Chardonnay, like
dirty Chardonnay.
It looks like
right.
Nasty ass Chardonnay.
Right.
Speaking of wine, in case you don't think Phil's being tortured enough,
don't no.
I have red wine. If you want to torture Phil more.
Mm-mm.
No.
I think this. This starts out fine, and then just that IPA aftertaste.
It starts out fine, and then it starts playing jingle bells in your head.
It starts out tasting citrusy, and then it turns into not citrusy anymore.
That smells nasty.
What's it turn into?
Okay, so the next one I'm going to do is the Atlanta Tart Plum Saison from Orpheus Brewing, which... Their logo is pretty badass, not gonna lie. Like, that is a cool logo.
Yeah.
That's cooler than can overall.
I like the sound of plum, but if you chose it to torture yourself, I feel like it tastes like shit.
Yeah. But yeah, so this is it says it's supposed to be refreshing. But it is a Saison, so it's gonna be really, really tart. It's 5.25% alcohol content. It doesn't look... See, I expected this to be kind of like a dark or like an amber color, and it looks like it's almost clear. This looks like champagne. Like, that's what this looks like.
Yeah.
It smells fruity. You might like this. I definitely don't. Okay, so the next one. I decided to end with New Belgium's Imperial IPA. I'm going to get, James, I'm giving you this bottle.
Oh, that is cool. Okay. I do know Voodoo Ranger has a lot of cool looking labels.
Yeah.
Like, that's the thing I know about any of their beers. Like, their bottles look
cool. I currently have a bottle of a cow.
Yeah.
Up there right now. So.
But yeah, like.
Yeah.
It's an Imperial. Imperial IPA, which means bitter. I'm looking for the alcohol. There it is, 9% alcohol by volume. So the generally the higher the alcohol content in an IPA, the harsher it is going to be. Yeah, that's about what I expect from like an IPA. Clear.
It's like a rosy color.
It looks like a...
Yeah, it looks like rosé.
Oh, no. There is no redeeming quality to that. Like, at least the hop-on had the citrus flavor. That is, like, beer-tasting beer with pininess and bitterness. Like, it is full of sadness. Like... yeah. Yeah. There was no... As somebody who is not a...
Let's see the bottle.
What?
Let's see the bottle again.
See the bottle?
Yeah. That's what Phil looked like after he
died. Yeah. Yeah, so... Yeah, no. Anyway, I need your guys' rankings on the beer. I already think I know them. 100%.
So, from worst to best, it is worst, then Wild Night, and the best today, yeah. Which, reminder, does not mean good to me, is the Vanilla Porter by Breckenridge Brewery. Congratulations, Breckenridge. You've made a beer that, if all my other options were exhausted, I'm talking cider, hard liquor, all they had was just a shit ton of beer. I would maybe get this. Well, James, what are your rankings?
I actually agree with you this time.
Wow. He actually likes some of them.
I actually like them. Except this one, I'm not sure I would get that one.
Are you going to drink that tonight?
That was weird. Yeah.
It's a pretty can.
I guess it's nice, but if you're naming a beer, like, I don't automatically think about sunscreen as I'm drinking beer.
Yeah.
All I can think about is bleached coral reefs when I drink this beer.
Do you like the Great Barrier Reef? Well, don't drink SPF. Well, we know which beer's not giving us any money. All right. Well, we're out of time rolling on this, so we're going to wrap up now. I hope you enjoyed it. I question why if you did. Bye.